Hello, and welcome to Caydor's Musings, a subset of Adventures in Random. Which is mostly Caydor anyway, so I don't know why it has to be a subset. I'm just picky that way. I am feeling ecstatic now. I wasn't earlier today. For this, I have to thank Cora. Q-U-O-A-R-A. I may not be pronouncing that right. .com. I regularly browse through this for inspiration. Sometimes you can find a question you can answer, and you do a post for it instead of answering the question there. You answer it briefly and expand on it further, or whatever you want to do to find inspiration. But today it inspired me in a different way. It inspired me to remember what I've been preaching for months in my perspective series, because they are good lessons, but it can be hard to maintain them at all times. Sometimes you need a reminder, and this question will do it for you. Called, what is the hardest thing you've ever had to do, you've ever done, or however they word it? Just that any one entry on that list is probably harder than anything you put up with in your day-to-day life. There are exceptions, of course, but you can still probably find someone that you're like, wow, mine's not quite that bad. I suppose I'm having a pretty decent day running into blazing buildings or whatever it happens to be. Now, in my first few takes for this, I went into detail on the story. But the guy wrote it so well that I don't feel I'm doing justice to it. And I'm not quite getting the energy I want to. I think part of it's being tired. I worked an extra day this week for overtime because we got things going on at work. And feeling exhausted to begin with. So I have this weird mix of like, I'm drained, but ooh, I'm happy to be alive. Because I almost thought I had problems there for a moment. My problems ain't nothing at all. They're tiny. I think dust is more significant than my problems in the grand scheme of things, because get enough dust together and they make the earth. Get enough problems together and you just have tiny, insignificant problems that don't really amount to much of anything in the grand scheme of things. Suffering of the human race. Mine's insignificant. So, I can't really feel bad about it anymore. I have this question to think. I will post a link to it. But, basically I think it's the very first one. Or the very first one on the list. I don't know how they order things. I think it's based on upvotes, but I'd have to double check. About the... starts off with picture of a gate, and the hardest thing you're going to do was walk through that gate. Very compelling story, and you must either be really cynical, really hard-headed, or really have a sucky life if your problems don't seem insignificant or easy after reading about the hardest thing he's ever done or any of the other ones. Because really, you that self-absorbed? I put my name on everything, and I'm not that self-absorbed. We had an item shop. Half of it would just be me duct-taping Caydor to random items to see who would buy it, because I love my name, and I'm starting to get the amount of energy I want in this. It should be fun and uplifting. And I was feeling very monotone in my first two ones. I liked what I was saying, but I was talking about like this. We're having an intimate moment, but just on the verge of creepy monotone. I was starting roaring myself, and I hear myself a lot. So thus me rise and fall to really convey meaning, because you can't see what I'm doing, and all these grand hand motions mean nothing to a microphone. Anyways, life is like a tesseract. With any one point you find in a corner defining where you're born, and another point defining where you die, and everything connecting those two just being thousands upon millions upon trillions upon whatever number you want to go to, because I'm getting bored with numbers already. That's how your life could play out. In the end, it will make probably a general shape similar to everyone else's, but it's the constants to make it up. Another beautiful thing about a tesseract is it kind of exists in four dimensions, so even if you have a pretty good idea of where you are on there, you may not be seeing where the next path leads. Someone get on that novel, Tesseract of Time. We may compete with the Wheel of Time series. I suggest going for a sword made of lightning if you're feeling particularly homage-y. Use a sword of fire. Lightning's better. It's like fire on steroids. And if you have it in sword form, you don't have to worry about that whole accuracy issue, because have you ever done the calculations for figuring out where a lightning bolt's going to strike? I attempted once. Never again. Never again. Never again. Ugh. Anyways. Thousands upon trillions upon billions upon quadrillions upon four. It's more than four, but I like the effect. And sorry for all the sniffing. I have like, it's like a head cold, but everything's dry. Basically, my nose is dry and all the snot is just kind of going down the throat. So I'll cut it out, but if I do it in the middle of something important, it can be hard to edit. And I could try redoing the take, but if it happens too many times, I probably just give up. Anyways, Tesseract of Life. Now you may say, well, life's fairly straightforward. I mean, can't really be all that complex. Well, it is. For every decision, there's, I don't know, millions upon gajillions of outcomes. I mean, you can, many of them are pretty common, but there's all sorts of things at play that you can't really affect or influence. Let's take the movie Groundhog's Day, for example. One fine example of the Groundhog's Day loop. The guy gets, or person, can be more than a guy, it's just the two or three I'm thinking of mostly involve guys. And some of them play with it, but generally the plot is they get stuck in a day. They have to repeat it over and 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 over again until they get it right. Problem is, life is so complex that most of them pretty well spend hundreds of years in that same day trying to figure out what they're getting wrong. Especially since they often like to tell people that they're stuck in a loop. But it's hard to convince someone, because as soon as you tell them that, you have to have the same conversation six times over, basically save-scumming life. And anyone who save-scum a particularly hard part knows that you can go through hundreds and hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of lives. I should know. I played, was it some sort of Super Mario game for the Wii U? Someone handed me someone else's controller with like 57 lives. Within an hour, I had four. I'm that bad at platforming. Ugh, platforming. Anyways, Tesseract of Life. But Bill Murray repeats that day in Groundhog's Day for like, I think someone figured it like 600 years. I'd check, but I really don't feel like it right now. I'm feeling bad that I'm not doing any posts, and I thought I'd just get this going, because I'm having fun with it. I've actually done three takes, and I've been talking to a microphone for over, basically over an hour. Just because this is strangely therapeutic. Anyways, Tesseract of Life. But he repeats it for what amounts to, I think, 600 years was the average guess based on all the skills he picked up. Trying to get this one day right. Though granted, he starts off a dick, so he mostly pisses away a couple hundred years sleeping with women and all sorts of other things when you realize you can't die. And he spends a good chunk of the middle of it just killing himself over and over again. And then he finally says, well, maybe I've been a dick. And he starts going through change. because many times a problem in that movie is, or a situation, I guess, is that they were the wrong person to start with, so they were naturally going to make the wrong decisions for that particular event. However, we don't get the redo. We don't get to save scum. We don't get to try it again and again and again. We get one shot, so we're likely going to fuck it up. Murphy's Law. In a system where there's an option of picking the wrong choice, you're generally going to pick the wrong one. But it's okay, because in the end, it doesn't really matter. I mean, yeah, things can go bad, and maybe something you enjoyed is over forever, but it's generally something more. I generally find it bad to rage quit life, because I always like to see how it's going to end, or how it plays out, I guess. We all know how it's going to end. Black screen and credits. Well, that's how I see the afterlife. Anyways, where were we? Just struck for life, no redos. Generally going to pick the wrong option. Yes. And I'm not just talking about big events. Big events you may get right, because those may be set in stone, depending on how you interpret fate and destiny and free will and all that, but mostly talking about the morally gray ones that are gray because they're not really on any sort of moral line. People might identify them as good or bad, but in the end, they're very innocuous. Even if that word is incorrect, I'm going to use it. Because I feel like saying innocuous today. And no, I don't have a word of the day calendar somewhere or anything like that. It just popped into my head and it fits. I like how it rolls off the tongue. Tongue. Innocuous. Innocuous. Woohoohoo! My energy's fading, so let's rise and fall again. Anyways. Innocuous. They don't mean much in the grand scheme of things, but in our immediate environment, they seem fairly big. Many of these are involved in intrapersonal interactions. Other human beings where you say something and they immediately assume the worst about you for it. Don't worry, it's called being socially awkward. It happens to the best of us. Some of us grow out of it, and some of us get by without letting it rise to the surface too often. But if you've watched any of my videos, or read a few of my articles, or listened to me in integer banter over video games, I can be a tad bit of a dick at times, so I have to keep that contained, because many people don't find that funny or appreciate that, or they don't think you're joking. And of course, if you just stay quiet all the time, they still assume the worst about you. Just how life is. Some days it goes on and on and on, and all you can do is just don't stop believing. Hold on to that feeling. See. Anything else? No, these have been averaging out to 15 minutes. Pretty proud of myself. Anyways, I don't know if this is going to be perspective 8, or just kind of a perspective side project. But I'm Caydor. That was one of my musings. Check me out on adventuresinrandom.com. If you want to look for more of the perspective series, it's go to adventuresinrandom.com, and you can either click Caydor's musings, or you can type /blog at the end of Adventures in Random. Then you can go down and click the under categories. You can click perspective, and you'll get a whole list of them. Or you can just continue after blog, do another /categories/perspective, and it'll take you right there. Fairly simple. I may even provide a link in the whatever if you want to get there. Or I may just do adventuresinrandom.com, because there's lots to check out. Anywho, let's wrap this up, shall we? Bye!
believe.